just like a spark that's breaking out. Can't make a start, can't turn back now. You know that there's no room for doubt. No, we can't turn back now. Sunrise, you know that we gon' light it up. Tonight.
you fade away. Afraid our aim is out of sight. Wanna see us alive. Where are you now?
Just like the street lights lit this town, like a fire in a blaze, gotta burn it down. Can't be afraid to leave this out. We got this far, don't know how.
Much for joining. Today we have another CML game, GG Kappa versus Team Ember. You have myself, The Anonymous, and CL with you in the Twitch stream today, and we are going to have some great games.
Great games indeed. People banning Marcy still, I see.
Well, the changes make her even more scary to play against, just because you don't know how the changes work yet. Not sure if everyone has tested it out, but hey.
I've got no idea. I've only played one game since the new patch.
Yeah, same. And it was quite a sad game for me, unfortunately. But interesting, though, the Alchemist ban coming out from GG Kappa. They must have seen Death Hunter on that Alchemist and said, there's no damn way we are even letting this thing go through the first phase.
I think the fact that... the pace of the games have been slowed because of level gaining being a little bit slower. I think that's how it works. I'm not even sure, to be honest.
So are you speaking about the rescale in the new patch?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's quite interesting. The rescale is less XP on the lower kills, but more XP on the higher experience or the higher streaks. So it can go either way. I mean, if you kill a hero on a high kill streak, you get a lot of XP. Oh, if you don't...
Not just that. You also need more gold to get to the next level as well. More experience to get to the next level.
That is a bit difficult, and I think supports in this meta is going to be quite rough with the 15% gold per minute decrease. That's quite hectic. They have implemented the new flag bearer creep, which could help, but it's going to be quite rough if you're a support trying.
Like gold every now and then, yeah. If you're even in the lane.
Exactly. So.
Alright, so this is a nice little pickup from GG Kappa, Jakiro and Zeus. Zeus is possibly a position for, I'm not sure what the changes are on the hero.
Yeah, so if we look at Zeus, let's quickly check the current changes. Has he been put into more of a core role?
Vengeful spirit.
Oh, and Avenge. I like that.
Haven't seen Avenge. That should be a support Venge. I mean, this guy. He only needs like an axe and a shard.
So Zeus was actually nerfed. His heavenly jump, the cooldown was increased. The slow has been decreased, and the slow duration has also been decreased. Then the static field has the health as damage has also decreased.
Okay.
Then his level 10 talent isn't 20 plus 20 movement speed. It's replaced with 350 health, which is fine, but I mean that 20 movement speed was quite nice. Then the other level 10 talent was 1.25 mana regen, was replaced with minus 4 seconds on the heavenly jump cooldown. And then the level 15 talent, the 350 health, was replaced with 30 movement speed after heavenly jump for 1.6 seconds. There has been quite a few changes. More nerfs, I think, than anything else.
So they're trying to make him tankier in the early game, I guess. Yeah. But I'm pretty sure it should. I mean, the fact that he's been nerfed that much, I guess he's still just a good position four, perhaps.
Yeah.
I would assume.
He's not going to get a lot of farm, so he's not going to go for that hectic kill potential. But I mean, he does want to be in those lanes, casting those slows, which has decreased. Interesting, though, with Vengeful Spirit, her magic missile is max range from level 1. So that's, you don't level it up from 575. It stays at 650 from level 1 all the way through, which is quite nice. So you don't need Shard for the bonus cast range. And the Shard bounce range now mirrors current cast range. So the bounce can't go further than the cast range. Still damn far.
Yeah, it's still pretty decent. It's still a decent pickup on this hero. Two stuns is crazy. It's a long stun, and it does a good amount of damage as well.
Yeah, and the Wave of Terror has also been buffed early game, so the damage has been increased from 70 to 85 damage early game, and then it exponentially increases there. But interesting, the level 10 talent, The 12% magic resistance was replaced with 150 nether swap damage.
Maybe that's for some people who get a blink dagger, then they can't immediately just blink out.
Yeah, I'm guessing so. And then the level 10 talent, the 10 agility, was replaced with 125 magic missile cast range.
Well, we'll see what on earth.
Okay, some interesting reworks on a lot of the heroes. I think this is going to be an interesting patch for just shaking up the meta a bit. I mean, some strong heroes like Dawnbreaker was buffed, which is quite nice for some people. And then other heroes have been suppressed that were quite strong in the game. So let's see what GG Kappa and Team Ember are going to do with this new meta. We see a bunch of bans coming out. I think normal bans, you've got the Jug, you've got the Bristleback. I mean, those two get banned out most games, and you've got the Viper. People don't like playing against those heroes, yeah?
Oh, no, absolutely not. Not me, for sure. I mean, Viper, nobody likes that guy.
Yeah.
Unless you are that guy. You like being that guy, but you don't like playing against
You them. Like being that guy. You like your Viper games.
Yeah, it's a nice little toxic guy, just spits poison at everybody.
Yeah. Interesting ban. That's probably because of the changes to that happened, is the Morphling ban. If you have Shard, you can now shift agility and strength while being stunned or disabled.
Just like stunned or like
stunned.
Silenced as well?
No, not silenced, just stunned.
Okay. All right. Okay. Well, it's still pretty good.
It's quite obviously.
Good. I wonder what they are going to pick for mid, because I feel like the mid lane has changed a lot since they took away that side camp.
Yeah, that's going to be quite an interesting matchup if you have your more farm intensive heroes going mid. I would like to see how they're going to get that farm up a bit faster. I think the stacks are going to be play a big role in this game.
Oh, by the way, this Earthshaker is actually a very dangerous pick for... I mean, it's a good pick for them, right? I wonder what they're gonna combo it with. Because
yeah.
Usually you can combo it with a Razor and then just dominate the lane completely. What are they gonna do now? Seeing as Team Ember picked Razor.
Yeah, so Earthshake hasn't got a lot of changes, just the cooldown on the Fissure was decreased. But the Queen of Pain has got quite an interesting few changes to it. So her axe was reworked. So Shadow Strike initial damage has been increased by 80 and is applied to all enemies in a 375 radius around the target. And when it ends or is reapplied to the enemy hero, the target emits a scream of pain, hitting any nearby enemies.
No, I saw that. That's like with an axe, right?
Yeah. So that's quite an interesting change-up. I don't know if I like it that much. If they're going to bunch
Team Ember
up,
must they just
nice.
Picked Quap, so they probably think it's something lethal to have on your side.
Yeah, maybe they're just testing it out. We'll have to see.
And obviously the drow pick, any cool changes there?
So with drow, I don't think a lot. The arrow damage, the multi-shot arrow damage was increased, but only in the earlier levels, so it's not that hectic. And then her talents have been reworked a bit, where the gust blind has replaced with movement speed. So if you gust someone, you gain 15% movement speed. And that's at level 10. At level 15, the gust width was replaced with gust reveals invisible units. It doesn't reveal wards. Then the level 20 talent, the bonus multi-shot damage has been decreased from 28 to 25. So not a lot of changes. Might be very helpful for First Blood, but not necessarily something that I think is game-breaking or meta-breaking at this stage.
Yeah, I mean, right now, GG Kappa, with this Earthshaker, I feel like their laning is going to be very, very scary.
Yeah, I mean,
thankfully, Team Ember did get a quap to at least blink out of those ganks, and Razor does have a lot of movement speed.
Yeah, and we've got the Venge swap.
GGK, but I'm talking about the laning phase only right now. So yeah. GGK with a stun and a ton of slows right now.
Yeah, I mean, if you think about a combo, if the Earthshaker is in lane and Jakiro comes, you're basically going to stand still for, what, 5-6 seconds before you can move if they combo correctly? I mean, that's good. And then there's still slows. So,
I think you're going to get away from that very easily.
No, this definitely looks like a BKB game for Team Ember all round.
I wonder if this is a Dawnbreaker carry. Maybe a Dawn position 4 with the Razor.
So Dawnbreaker, I think, with the changes, has become more of a support. So with the Shard, Dawnbreaker will start moving towards the area, if you cast Starbreaker, instead of standing still. So she has free movement, which is brilliant. With Celestial Hammer, the cast point has been improved, though the range has been decreased in earlier levels, which I think is a good nerf that needed to happen. Clinks. Oh, and a Clinks. We have not seen a Clinks in a while, but this Drow Ranger is going to enjoy the Gust talent.
Oh, of the spotting the Inverse. Let's. I hope to see that, actually.
I don't know if Team Ember noticed that change. Anyways, but with Solar Guardian, the Scepter allows to move the target area with a speed of 200. So you can actually move your Solar Guardian area.
Do you need an axe or something?
Yeah, you need axe.
Okay, but if this is going to be support Dawnbreaker, that's probably not going to happen.
Yeah. Maybe if
especially
she's...
with the changes on the 15% lesser gold per minute.
Yeah, that's going to be rough. Maybe the flag carriers actually make a difference. I don't think so, honestly. I think as a carry, you're going to enjoy that, but as a support, you're going to cry a bit.
We'll see. I think from, I'm struggling to see if the Sunbreaker's position 5 with the Clinks. I think that's what they're going to do.
I think Venge is going to be with the Clinks, and Dawnbreaker is going to go with the Razor and Queen of Fame mid.
But Dawnbreaker is going to be pretty good in either lane, I think, because she's got a nice little slow and that easy stun that's going to come out. So if she's comboed with the Razor, that is going to be very good against the Drow.
Yes.
All right, well, it seems like a Zeus middle against the Quap, and then I'm dying for the last pick. Any good changes on that guy before the game starts?
So we'll go to that now. Clinks has quite a few good changes, which is quite hectic to know about. The number of arrows have been increased in Burning Barrage, so it stays at a 6 from level 1. The damage per arrow has been decreased from 65% to scale from 50% to 65%, and the channel time has been rescaled to stay at a base 2 seconds. So
what was it?
It was 1.2 at level 1 and went up to 2.4 seconds. So
now it just stays at 2.
2 seconds, but that's still a ton of damage.
Yeah, but I guess that's only for the late game.
It stays there. I mean,
yeah, but it's better for the late game, because it's, like, obviously 2.4 means it takes longer, where now it's only taking 2 seconds, which means you're dealing more damage faster.
So remember, the amount of arrows cast is at a set amount, so 6 arrows.
Which means you're shooting 6 arrows in 2 seconds instead of 2.4.
Yeah, but it stays at 2. So it doesn't matter if it's late game, I mean. But that doesn't make you any sense. How did it go up with your levels? Anyways, so
I don't
we have...
Hero. I never played things.
No.
Maybe once or twice.
We have Team Ember versus GGK game 1. Let's get ready for some action. So, CL, you asked about the Undying. We'll go to that in a moment. See if there's going to be some funky gank action.
I mean, I feel like Team Ember can make something happen. They've got a bunch of slows.
Both teams can make stuff happen, but we have seen Team Ember play quite safe.
Tombstone on undying is always very scary. Oh, he doesn't even take it. So he just immediately goes for decay.
Well, that's quite interesting.
I guess they don't want to dive. They're a little bit afraid of running on up this ramp right now.
So, can I tell you why he's taken decay?
Please.
It has a major buff to it. So the debuff and buff no longer modifies your health when expiring. So enemies no longer gain health and Undying doesn't lose health when it expires. So you just continue to lose health every time it is cast on you until you die. There's no buff or debuff. That is quite strong.
Yeah, that's pretty rough. What's this Klings doing? 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, a nice little cookie throwing his celestial hammer there, but not going to be enough to get any kills, I don't think.
Oh, we've got a stun.
The stun came out a little bit late.
The range might not have been long enough. Almost first blood.
Only he came when the Klinks countdown started, maybe. But
yeah.
How many bounties were gotten?
Three, one. So I want to see how this works. Looking at the decay change up. But this is gonna be disgusting.
Which one?
This lane.
What with Undying?
Drow and Undying. My goodness.
Well, that was a really scary lane to go up against in the previous patch or two. So, yeah. This should still be very deadly. But I still want to see what this decay thing is all about.
So look at
he's
not going to lose HP, and the enemy is not going to gain HP. So you'll see the total HP of the heroes that he's using decay on decreases every time he uses it on them.
Wow, this Undying is creating so much space they can't do anything against it.
So just have a look at this. Check the max health of these heroes. It decreases.
Yeah, obviously.
But it doesn't come back again. Look at this damage.
The Razor actually looks like he's
This is going to be first blood.
First blood for the drow.
My goodness, this lane is disgusting. Wow.
The slow and the ridiculous strength steal from Undying is just too much.
Yeah. So we do see Burning Barrage coming out at the level 2. It looks like Beaver wanted to go on this Jakiro, but nothing happening much there. So CL, do you wanna introduce the lanes for us? We can start at top.
Alright, let's have a quick look. Battle Drome on Earthshaker. Is this gonna be the position 3, I believe? And then we've got the Jakiro played by Gubster? Alpha Gubster? Position 4, and with the Klinks position 1 for Death Hunter playing in the time of team in the side of Team Ember, and then Beaver on Venge position 5. Now, I don't know, this lane kind of looks even right now, or what do you think?
It does look even. I think XP wise, Shaker's gonna have a good time because he's quite tank, and Klinks at level 2 doesn't do that much damage, but he has to be careful. He's got a Venge and a stun that is thrown out for the harass. So I think it's pretty even. Last instant denies wise, I don't think either of these two are just going to come out far at the top. I think it's going to be very, like you said, even.
Yeah, but with this Earthshaker just buying a brace or two,
yeah,
I think he's actually going to be able to kill this, the Clinks, as soon as he hits level 6, I feel like.
Yeah,
Clinks is he tanky? I don't think he is.
No, he's really not. He actually can kill both of these heroes if they're out of position with a full creep wave.
Well, look at the damage already. Half HP and Clinks. I think this is going to be a little bit rough, as the more this lane progresses, it's just going to get harder.
Definitely. Let's go over to the mid lane.
So, what is this Zeus's name? Hakon? What is this? Hekatonkir. Man, whatever.
Fuck.
This guy is playing Zeus. and Blackie's 5000 is playing Quell.
Oh my goodness.
I feel like Zeus, you said he was nerfed a lot.
Yeah.
So I wonder how's the laning going? Zeus is ahead in 2 CS right now.
Yeah, but I mean, he's got Arc Lightning that's quite good for these CSs. I mean, Queen of Pain has the Scream, so that's always good. But I feel like damage-wise, it's even. I mean, this has got a lot of burst damage, but I don't know. I don't know about.
Yeah, they both got an escape, right? I mean, look at this jump from Zeus just now.
Yeah.
They both can just get out of the way if things look scary. Quap can just blink. Zeus can just jump. Obviously, Quap probably has a little bit of the upper hand.
Yeah.
Especially at level 6. I mean, Quap can probably just. Shadow Strike, Scream of Pain, and Sonic Wave, and then Zeus is most likely dead there.
Yeah, no, definitely. I think the Ooh, speed of the combo. Oh my goodness.
People just got a kill on Jakiro.
Yeah.
I believe they were like fighting for this little camp here that they pulled.
But
anyways.
Death Hunter needs to be careful. He's very low. I mean, we've got level 2 in Enchanted Totem. That's one stun and one hit, and he's dead.
Yeah, Zeus, for some reason, ran into the Quap just now. I missed that while we were looking at top. But, yeah, Zeus is forced to TP back.
But we do see a kill on the Drowned bot. We're missing these fights because we're looking at the other lanes. Jeez. Not sure what happened there. Must have. Well, it definitely was a static link. And they stunned, so that was a good thing.
Yeah, I mean, if they go, they can't kill on dying, I don't think. This guy's just too tanky.
Yeah, I think he is.
And I think as soon as he drops Tombstone, they either have to run or just destroy it as quickly as possible. Can you fight against the Tombstone in this game?
I think Clinks is gonna die. But they were a bit slow there. I don't know if Earthshaker ran the wrong way around. But
Clinks looks fine, man.
Yeah, but Earthshaker had him stunned and blocked.
Ooh,
oh my
god.
Takes out Death Hunter with that ult. Is there going to be a chase? It looks like. Nope. He does
all
not
right,
want
so
to Clinks chase.
Clinks does
that.
Not look fine.
No, Clinks is not fine at all. But Quap is level 6, and I don't know if she's going to go for this.
Well,
looks
she doesn't
like
have Blink, so.
Yeah,
maybe after she hits the next level, she might go for a sneaky kill.
That was well, I guess she doesn't need a save against.
Well, she's got Blink now. Zeus is just hiding in the tree line.
Yeah.
He knows. He knows this Quap leveled up and she's ready to go on him. By the way, let's again go to the bottom lane. How do you fight against this Tombstone?
Well, I don't know, but it looks like there's a lot of damage coming from this drown, a lot of slow. Do they want to dive, though?
No. No, Undying doesn't have any mana, unfortunately.
Yeah, that would have definitely been a kill if he had Doomstone there.
Oh, I think we saw a Sonic Wave miss, maybe, or something?
Yeah. Must have missed. And top, Jakiro falls again.
Oh, Clinks as well, though.
Yeah, but this Earthshaker is level 6 and he's chasing down. Or is he just gonna.
So he's at level 6 now. He still has his Echo Slam ready. So if Clinks does come back, he's only level 4.
Yeah, that is quite rough.
Dawnbreaker also decides to come in.
This might be...
And they spot him. And this is a kill on the Dawnbreaker. But I feel like this Beaver is just... Are they going to at least kill him? There we go. Klings finally gets that last hit.
I think Beaver just didn't want to take that last hit because it's obviously he had a kill streak. So that does give him that extra gold.
Nice. So a little bit more experience and everything.
Yeah. Definitely worth it. Mid, we see Zeus and Jakiro trying to make play on Quap.
Nah, I don't think they can, right? Unless Quap, like, blinks in, I don't think they can get him.
I would like you to just check this rune placement for that the Undying just did. I'm not sure if you can see my ping.
Nope.
Okay, so if you look at the right side... at the ruin where Dawnbreaker is. Right there on the edge, there's a ward placed by Undying. It's a pretty good ward because it's not going to be dewarded easily, and Zeus knows Dawnbreaker is right there.
Yeah. He spots it out, the Dawnbreaker out, and I mean, let's see. Is he going to be brave or is he going to be smart?
Well, let's see what's happening here.
Alright, well, they're diving it.
Yeah, they are diving and they're gonna get that kill. Zeus does not get his ulti off.
Tombstone.
Undying commits Tombstone.
It's for nothing, though. It's
for nothing.
Complete waste. I guess he's just gonna stay middle a little bit, get some experience. While this
You see a fight going on bot. Jakiro dies again.
Wow, the rotations from Cookie really.
Yeah, Earthshaker is doing a ton of damage though. Goodness.
No, this Cookie is doing plays, man. He's almost level 6 and ready to rotate even more.
Definitely doing well.
In the bottom lane, Razor against a Drow. I feel like Drow cannot really lane against this guy.
Yeah, Undying.
She's gonna static link and then she has to run.
Undying, right, let's look Flesh at Golem again. Oh, well, Flesh Golem now.
Flop coming out, but. Anything else? Wow. That's a big amount of damage coming out from the Earthshaker. Zeus dies to the Klinks. Echo Slam used. Flop. Hit.
Oh
but
my
nobody's
goodness.
Going down, though.
What? He missed.
That Echo Slam on the Quap who blinked in, but it just didn't make any difference, though.
So I think he was struggling to make a choice on who to kill first, the Quap or the the Avenger, and he made the wrong choice going on the Quap.
So, yes.
Quite rough. But Quap baited out Undying's Flesh Golem as well now in mid. Baited it out and then left to go gang top. So it was quite a good move there from Quap. So, something interesting I'm noticing on the stats, though. It's been quite a fight-intensive game. I mean, 8 kills or 16 kills, 12 minutes in the game. They've been fighting, brawling a lot. And usually with new patches, that is what we see. Just for everyone to figure out exactly what's working and what's not working.
Look at the bottom lane. Drow is running around, trying to dodge all the spells.
And wow, Cookie coming in. My goodness, Cookie has
Troll of Guardian actually healing the Razor up enough to kill the Drow, but he does die eventually as well.
But that does mean that Zeus is pulled from mid
to try
to
and
no avail. I mean, yeah, that does secure the kill, but this Cookie has been making plays all over the map.
Yeah, no, this guy's been moving around a lot. Really good rotations. He's always in the fights. I guess that's why we see all these fights. This guy's just making the plays.
Jakiro's gonna die, 100%. Great swap and stun. Ballwise takes that kill.
Being spotted out, though. Is he gonna just TP out? I don't think he even can. Venge is there for a stun.
Yep. If she uses a stun first and he doesn't die instantly, he
TP
can TP out. He's trying to make it, but he just doesn't.
His courier falls as well.
Oh my goodness. This might be... Nah, they haven't got enough damage to take this mid tower between Zeus and Undying.
Zeus and Undying. They definitely do not bridge towers, that's for sure.
Yeah, definitely not. Man, I really thought this Undying would have made a bigger difference in the game with the change to decay.
We'll see, the game is not over yet.
Yeah, but I thought early game he would have wrecked. Like, I mean, he does. But he did not make as big of an impact as I thought.
Well, he is still, I think, a pretty tanky guy. If he's in the front line, I don't think he's just going to die anytime soon.
So we got...
See, though. Swap on the from hero. He dies to Blit, actually to the Sonic Wave.
Solar Guardian. Guardian comes in.
Middle of the fight. Undying dies as well. For nobody, nothing. Nobody on Team Ember died. What a great fight for them, actually.
Goodness.
Be careful. Echo Slam's still there.
Yeah, they need Andy.
If he wants to. Oh, what a stun.
Oh my goodness. Venge does not know how close they were all to dying.
No, but that Venge stun came in just in time.
Perfect timing, because if he ulted there in between the trees, it would have been a lot of damage.
That would have been a few kills, I think. So well done to Beaver. With the quick fingers.
Yeah, and Zeus ulti was ready, so that would have been a big difference.
Look at the quote. My life flashed before my eyes. Your life did.
That definitely did, we have to say. So I want to check something quick. This Dawnbreaker is really playing well for me. I mean, Cookie's been in so many of these fights. He would push out the lanes and wait for a team fight to happen. Solo Guardian on top of them.
He looks like he's gonna get mana now.
I mean, it's
Doomstone used as well. Shakira there with the ice wall to stop him. Quick kill for the Earthshake.
But I mean,
that's a great fall though. That's really.
And I mean, oh my goodness! Yeah.
Instantly used on the Klinks. Well, Klinks was very brave to stand there.
Venge also gonna get gone on. She's definitely not gonna make this one.
Oh, what? Easy swap. What? Easy swap, and.
But we've got Blink.
The end of this freaking Earthshaker with his hits.
Look at this. Is she gonna get away?
Yeah,
goodness, like he does get away.
Dying is in a very tight spot right now. He's just gonna TP.
Wait,
too late. However, the Earthshaker is spotted and he cannot blink because of the Shadow Strike on him right now. Chikira also falls to the swap. Another Shadow Strike coming out. I think this is it for you, Battledrome. You did. That was a good fight, but unfortunately, he could only get the Klinks at the beginning.
And they did not even get the Venge. That was probably on 5 HP at that point.
You know, they really did commit hard for that.
They committed so much. We do see Razor going on mid. Is he going to get this kill?
Zeus does not have Heavenly Jump already, so he might actually die here.
But this is quite deep. Swap out from Venge. Stun from Venge.
Drow joining the fight as well to try and kill at least... We might get double kill here.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Great kill for Logic. Those are two key kills that are definitely needed. And oh my goodness, Chikara dies again.
We missed that one completely. But I think Quap is just gonna push this tower now. Well, no, wait. Earthshaker is here to make an end to this push. Look at this damage. Zeus is here too. Kill the Quap eventually as well. I mean, that was like 2-3 seconds and the Quap was dead. So just control from the Earthshaker is more than enough to kill this Quap.
That is insane. I cannot believe how fast that Quap died. BKBs are definitely supposed to be next in line. I see Quap is going Mage Slayer and then BKB. It's fine, it's not an expensive item, but BKBs are becoming a necessity right now. There's just so much magic damage coming out from the side of GG Kappa.
Okay, Klinks does smell a gang coming in. This drow is looking for him, hunting. Is he gonna get him though? He spots him.
She does not have level 15 yet. Solar Guardian used just to save the Klinks.
Was it even needed though, Aaron?
No, I don't think so.
They're still gonna hunt though.
And they might get
Drow running in. Zeus in the middle of the fight, actually at the back. Oh boy, Cookie does die to the Zeus, who is so deep in their own jungle right
now. We do see two sentry wards placed right next to each other, just to make sure they spot.
Wow! The Klinks barrage just killing the Zeus.
Oh my goodness, that is crazy.
I mean, I think the Zeus was running in vision of this outpost, so the Klinks just knew exactly where he was.
Yeah.
That is a big misplay. Quapper's gear gonna annoy Battledrome a little bit. But Pian Echo Slam used, and Quap actually dies again to Earthshaker.
Earthshaker core is strong. You get level 4 enchanted totem, you do a ton of damage.
Wow.
She needs to be careful of this. She can't fight without her BKB. She can easily kill him with her BKB. Lol, yeah. My team told me not to do it. We agree with your team.
Definitely.
Smoke in mid.
Alright, Ray's are gonna be in the front.
Well, he's got such freaking fast movement speed. 550 right now, so he can run around the whole world with that movement speed.
Maybe he can find a Jakiro, maybe? No. I mean, this is a dangerous spot to be in right now.
Yeah.
Klinks is just chilling in their jungle. So I don't think if they should be making this play right now. Drow might run into that. I think, did he see the Klinks? They're just gonna farm up.
Yeah, so they are farming quite hard. Klinks is on 155 last hits, and the Drow is on 127. So the Klinks is farming very well. But if we look at the net worth, the Drow is ahead by 400 gold. And that's probably because of the kills she's gotten.
The Dawnbreaker has been struggling to find a good fight. I think that's because his corpse has been dying too fast.
Yeah.
Lately.
Venge is seen. Solar Guardian comes in, does get the undying. That. He should die.
Tombstone is top of the hill. Undying half HP all of a sudden, by the way. Whoop with a sonic wave onto the Drow, killing him. Drow dead.
Trying to get
Hero
this
throwing out his ice
wall
onto the Razor, who might actually go down here, slowed and stunned. Klinks dead to
everyone dies.
Tombstone?
This tombstone just wrecked them. They
was
could
the
not.
Tombstone? How did he die?
The tombstone. They got a ward here. The tombstone spotted him. Last hit was done by one of the zombies, but this tombstone on top of the heel or ward spot was brilliant. They could not get it down. Well done to Undying. That was definitely his fight to win.
Echo Slam not even utilized, by the way. So they're still
My
ready to go.
Goodness. And that puts two of the cores of GG Kappa on top of the net worth. Drow on 10,000 net worth. Oh my goodness. Are they going to bring this back, or are they going to let it slide? We've seen many
right
games.
Right, Shaker looks scary. He's got a shard. Reduces Fissure cooldown.
The shard is hectic. So
Smoke used on an Invis Klinks, who is barraging almost all of them. Echo Slam right on top of the Klinks. And he is dead right at the beginning of the fight.
That
the
shard
Kira burning everybody.
My goodness.
And that's the end of the fight, it seems.
Not sure if it is.
Are they going to break up and get back, or are they going to go again?
They need to be very careful. The side of Team Ember need to be very careful. The Team GG Kappa look very strong. So this shard is one of my favorite
shards in the game. It has aftershock along the whole fissure. So if you stun someone, you can stand on a whole different spot, use Enchanted Totem, and that continues to stun them. And it increases the damage of your Echo Slam as well if you Echo Slam on top of a fissure. So that's
a lot of control.
A lot of control. BKBs are now more needed than ever. And yeah, they look quite... Razor has his BKB. Okay, Razor should be fine. Yeah, that is definitely...
So you're in a tight spot.
Yep. He should fall from this.
Yeah, no, this is a quick and easy kill. Cookie, somehow finding him.
Yeah, that was well done. Cookie's all doing right. A brilliant job. Struggling to find when to jump in. I mean, with GG Kappa just making sure they know that there is a Cookie on the loose. We do see a smoke up.
Oh, I mean, Echo Slam ready in 20 seconds, so they've got a tiny opening right now.
They need to kill him first.
He's dead as well. Razor does spot him, unfortunately misses the plasma field. Alright, Glinx, like they know exactly where you are.
Yep, they do. So many wards in this mid lane, all spotted.
So right now, I feel like if GG Kappa goes into Rosha, does team Ember have what it takes to stop them?
I think if the barrage comes out and they're in Rosh Pit, it's going to be quite hectic. We have Solar Guardian that is also quite hectic. But I don't think in the end that they can take that fight. I mean, with Tombstone and Flesh Golem.
Yeah, no, I don't think they have what it takes to stop this objective from happening. But it doesn't seem like GG Kappa is going to take it, though. They're just going to farm up, split up with the Drow going top, and the rest of Team Ember just splitting up and defending mid and pushing bottom.
Yeah. So,
let's see. GG Kappa smoked up.
Undying is going to be the first one whose smoke breaks. Ward placed in the mid.
Shaker catching.
That is
Cookie.
A very dead Cookie.
Yeah. No, this Shaker is making plays right now. He's doing.
He's got his axe. He's got his axe as well. That's a scary item. And we've only got a BKB on this Razor. Man.
Ozquop still miles away.
Yeah.
Thanks. 1,200 gold. Maybe 2-3 minutes away. Oh boy. So if...
What do you do in this position, CL?
If
you're
really
a team member. I mean,
really
you
rough.
Can't fight, but you can't not fight. What do you do?
I mean, I guess you got a split push. You just got a split push. Quap is probably the safest split pusher that they have right now. Or the Klings. I mean,
well, they've got a lot of vision on this Klings. They keep buying wards, they keep having dust.
Yeah, but what I was about to say is even if they do split push and this Earthshaker is hiding in the trees, he does more than enough damage to kill either the Klings or the Quap, probably by himself. And they even do have a Zeus with an Axe. Nimbus and Thunder God's Wrath Tombs.
We do see the first rush happening.
Yeah, no, there's nothing. Team Ember's not going to be able to stop this. I don't know if they even know about it, but even whether they do or not doesn't really make any difference.
Yeah, I don't think they can do anything.
Okay, BKB on the Klings now.
Okay, that's a good thing. Very good thing.
Razor, what's his next item? Is it gonna be Sangha Yasha? Or, I mean, you don't refresh your orbs. Isn't that nerfed like really hard right now? 350 mana just to use a refresher at the moment?
That is quite rough.
That's crazy. I mean, I feel like you gotta buy Soul Ring if you wanna buy Refresher eventually.
Frick, man.
Or at least the Shivas.
So that we do see Klink's down bot trying to split push. He's probably gonna take this tower if he sees Gigi Kappa. Which he does. And he's comfortable in taking this tower.
This is the right move. Now for the rest of team member, the right move would be to fight high ground. Okay, Earthshaker.
Swapped
into the base, but he's just hopping out though. Where
instant
is it down?
Death.
Now we've
what?
Got a Dawnbreaker in the middle of the fight as well.
Razor
Klink's
keeping
back, but how do you have to fend with only you and Pop left?
You can't. I mean, Razor, as soon as his BKB died, it was dead.
Just got his BKB off in time because Earthshaker was about to blink in, but nobody even dies.
Nobody even dies. BKB's committed on both. My goodness.
Blinks dies. As soon as his BKB ran out, he died. Drow's stuck, but who cares? He's got an Aegis.
My word.
Yeah, now right now there's 13k lead, and what about the experience lead? That's like 10 levels.
If you look at the change, it's been fine for the last 10 minutes, and then all of a sudden, major timing with this blink, with this axe on Earthshaker. It just...
5% win probability.
What do you do? I don't see a way out of this right now. BKBs don't last long enough for them to do enough damage.
Yeah, and this Earthshaker is just jumping out. He doesn't care.
I mean, Klinks does not have enough damage right now. He's going for Shod as well.
They do spot him out, but is this gonna be enough to kill him? He hops away. Again. Swapped back, but again, he hops away. Quap jumping in. But does not have Sonic Wave.
BKB used.
Running deep, trying to kill. Perhaps I'm dying. Turns around.
BKB was committed so early on the Razor. He's gonna go down.
Thunder God's Wrath to kill the Razor. I mean, they can't find any of the kills. Okay, I'm dying. Does die to Rocket Barrage from the.
But I mean, Drow still has Aegis. They haven't even claimed Aegis on the Drow. They've got the Jakiro, they've got the Undying, but they did not claim Aegis. That's a fact.
I think that's almost as good as these fights can go for Team Ember, but if they did get the Earthshaker, that would have been, like, the dream, right?
But he didn't even use Echo Slam.
He just hops away. This guy is so tanky.
So tanky, so mobile, he just doesn't care right now. It's actually crazy. But I feel like the side of Team Ember just don't do enough damage right now. I mean, Klinks needs something that's gonna put him back on this map. If we look at the last hits and denies, Klinks is ahead by 60 last hits, but on the net worth, he's only sitting third with a 2k deficit from this Drow. I mean,
we can see that Bar's Barwise doesn't know what he should buy.
Yeah, I mean, it's a hard game.
I think he was queuing up an Orchid. I'm not sure if I saw correctly, but now then he changed it to a help.
We do see Undying taking a lot of damage. Jakiro's gonna fall.
But he does get an Ice Wall on two, and then an Echo Slam coming out as well. Klinks does use BKB to try and survive these stuns. Undying slowly dying to the Quap. Okay, so this is again the same two people dying, Undying and the Jakiro. But Earthshaker just keeps getting away.
They need lockdown on this Earthshaker. I mean, I think Orchid would have been a good move on the Razor.
Well, I think they're going to go for Orchid on the Quap right now, because she's got it queued up.
Yeah. She's not bad.
No, of course not.
I just feel like their damage has been so Little.
Well, let's see the gold swap there. It's not that big though. It's only at 1.2k gold swap.
It's not
in this fight, but the experience. How much? Where do you see the experience?
So, in total, since 28 minutes, but Quap might die. Nope, she blinks out. But the stun is there. Oh my goodness.
Quap needs to use.
Yep.
Blinks dies slowly, being burned and slowed by the ice arrows.
Yeah, so this is quite rough. Two major cores die on the side of Team Ember. And I mean, they both used... No, they didn't use their BKBs. Why wouldn't they have used their BKBs? Could they not have gotten away?
I mean, I think the Kling's position was just... He was behind the enemy. Like,
but
they
then
were just chasing him.
This is probably a Rax?
Does look like it. Kling's does not have buyback. Glyph used to try and prolong this push.
But I mean, Drow eats towers for breakfast.
And Jakiro as well, don't forget about the dragon.
Yeah, he's got Liquid Frost as well. He's got his shard.
Now this Rax is definitely gonna go down, but what are they gonna do after this? Are they just gonna go back into the jungle? Or are they just straight gonna go back for the bottom push?
Well, I think it's fine to say that they've got enough damage to push bot out and end the game. Right now, they're in a very good spot. They've got great items. The next few items are quite a few gold away for everyone on the side of GG Kappa. So, I would say push bot, get Rax.
I mean, Roche is back in 30, so...
Possible 30. It could still be 2 minutes and 30 seconds, I think, after that.
Yeah, true that. So, what is the pause for? Is this little lag going on for somebody?
Yeah, I think someone had some issues. Not sure.
Maybe there's someone at the gate.
Maybe they are getting their pizza or something. Maybe they're having a team motivational talk. I don't know. So, see,
not even allowed?
No, I'm joking. I don't think they're allowed to do that. they probably can do that because they're in-game in Discord, so they can motivate themselves. They can't pause for it, though. Maybe just some connection issues or that mouse battery dead or something. Not sure, but it's fine. It's not a long pause. But, I mean, CL, what do you do in a game like this? This, I don't know how you beat this Earthshaker. They do not have enough damage. They do not have silence. I mean, Orchid's only going to come out after the Shaker has his BKB. I mean, what do you do? I don't see a way.
I feel like they're just way too far behind right now. This Shaker's got too much. They can't control him.
And they're going to catch out
the rest
Cookie
of Chichi Kappa.
Then sacrifices.
Out, but he just dies as well, though.
I mean.
So, yeah, no, this is really hard to deal with. GG Kappa's got a very, very strong lead right now.
Yeah, and I mean, you've got the free D Ward Zeus running around just taking out all the newly placed wards.
The sentry, the moving sentry.
Yeah.
Call him. Alright, BKB used from the Klinks as a last resort.
But I mean, he's still taking so much damage from the drow. Even
what?
While he's using
Razor it. Gets away with nothing. Oh no. Alright, here we are in game 2 of GG Kappa versus Team Ember. Game 1 was a very firm victory for GG Kappa with that Earthshaker MVP. I wonder, are they going to try and ban that thing out? Because that does look like a very strong pick for their offlaner.
That is a very strong pick. I think this Elk is definitely a respect ban because Death Hunter is quite good on that Elk. But are they going to let this Earthshaker through? I mean, it's a flex pick, so they can pick him first and have him run past 5 if they want to, or past 3 if the game looks good for it. So they choose to ban the Undying rather than the Earthshaker.
So the Undying definitely did make that lane really easy for the Drow Ranger.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
Created a crap ton of space.
So let's see. What did they pick first in the previous game? Remember those. We need to write those picks down so we can remember these things.
Yeah, we definitely do. They picked up the Zeus second. I'm trying to remember what they picked up first.
Well, right now they've got the Warlock.
Yep.
With a shard on that guy is a very strong.
Well, Dazzle and Axe. That's a fast pickup from them. I'm guessing they have planned this.
I wonder. You've told me that people have been playing Dazzle mid lately.
So
is that still a thing?
I don't think it's meta. I think it's just more for memes. I think Dazzle is quite strong, but I do think he's not a proper mid hero if you're looking at 5v5 games. So Dazzle was actually nerfed a bit. The duration of Shallow Grave was decreased in the earlier levels, or actually at all levels, but 0.5 seconds, so it's not that much. Does make a big difference in long team fights. And the Shadow Wave heal has also been decreased by 5 points. Oh, early game it's by 20 points, and it just scales up from there. That's a lot of nerf to Dazzle's heal.
I believe the Dazzle is still a very good support, surely.
He is, definitely, but the nerfs are quite hectic, I have to say. I did not expect it to be that bad. Then Axe has been nerfed slightly. Strength and agility decrease has been, or strength and agility gain has been decreased. The strength by 0.6, which is quite substantial, especially early game. But the Berserker's Call, the cost point has been increased to 0.3 seconds, so it's a bit faster. The Battle Hunger Slow has been increased in earlier levels. The Counter Helix max stacks have now gone up to 6, which is one more. But the damage reduction has been, the shard damage reduction has been moved to 15% instead of the 20. But Culling Blade has also got a longer range now, so.
What?
Yeah.
Can you use Culling Blade from further away?
Yeah, instead of 150, 175. So it's not a big difference, but it can be a big difference in those crucial team fights.
Yeah, I'm sure there have been many moments where that would have made a difference.
Yep, definitely.
So, okay, I wonder why we saw the Weaver ban. What is the idea there? Is it a Weaver Dawnbreaker? Is that some thing that might be scary or something?
I think so. Not sure. Just interesting, though, the shard on the Warlock has been nerfed. So the heal and damage has been decreased on early levels. It stays the same at max level. Then it no longer provides that movement speed buff.
No.
Yeah. Which is quite a big nerf because that movement speed buff was...
was awesome.
Was very hectic.
Everybody just running faster and the enemy team running slower.
That was a big team fight. I think that's why they had to nerf it. And we see a Hoodwink. I liked their previous Hoodwink game. They really played well with it, and we saw that hero do a ton of damage.
Yeah, I'm he was not sure.
But I'm not sure if it is. It could be position 4. I mean, with an axe, the slow and the damage axe can just culling blade after he's done that simple combo. So, no, it's quite hectic. Another thing on the warlock, the upheaval slow has also been increased, but it now deals increasing amount of damage from 10 up to a maximum of up to 90 every second. So that's quite a big buff, but the cast range has also been decreased though.
By the way, they did pick up a Monkey King on GG Kappa, which is very strong laner against the axe.
Yeah.
So I feel like that's going to suck a ton for this guy. He's not going to have a good climber, I don't think.
And we see a Void Spirit. I have been wanting to see this Void Spirit mid for quite some time. Has been banned out most of the games. I'm so glad. I don't know. We didn't even bet on the previous game. You know that.
Or we can just... no, we didn't. So what can they pick against the Void Spirit? Like Tiny, maybe a, rather a Puck, or even a Nightstalker?
You know, I think I would like a Puck. Just to lock down some of these heroes. But you're looking for something that's going to get Monkey King out of his ult. You won't...
Oh, but Tusk does that very easily, but...
Yeah, Tusk with... Is it Shard that does that? Have they reworked Tusk as well? Or that's Axe? Yeah, so...
I think we kind of do need to see the mid pick here, because I think GG... If they don't, I think GG Cap is going to ban all the good picks against the Void Spirit. And they go for the Kunkka.
Kunkka is a good pick against this Void Spirit, I think. They're going to...
Void Spirit can't just burst him down, so yeah, he's going to be fine.
That too, and he's got X marks the spot, so Void Spirit is going to be very creative with his dodges. Kunkka being able to time that properly will make life of Void Spirit very hard when he reaches that level 6. Bring him back after he's done a massive combo but not killed someone. So I like this Kunkka pick a lot.
You can also bring the Dawnbreaker back if she tries to run a ulti out.
Solo Guardian, yeah. Definitely. You can bring the monkey back when he jumps up on trees. So Kunkka was a great pick on the side of Team Ember. But I am wondering, what are they going to do against this Monkey King? The Kunkka has got a lot of burst in the Hoodwink as well, but...
Yeah, right now, Monkey against an Axe in the lane is going to be tough.
I wonder if they might swap the lanes, though. Have Axe...
They might.
I would think that's very important, because Axe is going to have a shite lane against the Monkey King.
Yeah, Monkey is just going to be full HP almost... Always. Time, so...
Yeah, you're going to call him and you're going to be like, oh crap, I shouldn't have called him.
Should have called something else.
Should have called the creeps.
Definitely true.
So no, it's going to be quite rough. And I mean, if they want to cut the wave, Monkey isn't going to care. He's going to come and smack you in the face. So it's really a good pick against this Axe.
Yeah, the mobility on Monkey makes it very easy for you to for him to just get on top of you. If you do try to cut the wave. So let's see. The off lane seems to still be open for GG Kappa.
Yeah, they picked the off lane or the POS 4 last in the previous game, which was quite interesting. Or POS 5, sorry. Which was quite interesting. I'm wondering what this Dawnbreaker is going to do. Is she going to be off lane? Is she going to be support? I would like to see. What's
tell
him
right now? I think they might. I mean, why not another Earthshaker? I guess it can block the lanes again. It she can. He can just blink right in on top of the Axe or control.
Can I tell you what I want to see? I want to see a Primal Beast.
With an Axe.
With
Primal
an Axe.
Beast with an Axe. That would be nice. I haven't seen that yet.
So the reason why is because Primal Beast. With Monkey King can take out the backline so fast.
We just see a cute little Crystal Maiden.
It's interesting that they picked their POS 5s last. I like it. I like it a lot.
So, Primal Beast definitely not. Well, I guess Team Ember can still go for a Primal.
No, don't think Team Ember wants to go the Primal Beast.
But the on GG Kappa, they are probably just going to play a very high-paced game, I think. Because if Monkey gets a very good lane, especially if he does lane against the Axe is going to be very far behind and farm. Well, the Monkey is just going to snowball, I think.
Yeah.
I mean, if it happens, we'll see what happens exactly. But Dawnbreaker is the only real frontliner for them.
Well, unless they throw Crystal Maiden in the front, but I don't think that's a good idea. And they've got Warlock ult. I mean, you have
Phantom Assassin.
We got the PA. PA has been said to be quite broken this patch. She has gained lifesteal on Phantom Strike for the duration of Phantom Strike. So it starts
how much lifesteal?
10% and goes up to 25%.
Wait, Battledrome is playing CM, so this is a position 3 CM?
Oh, that is interesting. So she is going to front line.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Well, that's...
All right, sorry, how much lifesteal does the PA have?
10% at level 1, 25% at level 4.
It's not too bad.
That's really not bad. You can farm a lot faster now.
Yeah, no, heck, you just go to the jungle, you're going to be fine. You're going to heal up from the creeps quite easily.
Yeah.
So we
do see Cookie on the Hoodwink, which means that it's a pause for Cookie. I think it's going to be great against this Monkey King, because even though he's good against this Axe, I think the Monkey King's going to be harassed quite hard by this Hoodwink.
Well, Monkey does have a Warlock in his lane, so he's going to have a lot of sustain. Not only from his own Jingu mastery, but also from the heal coming from Warlock. Yep. So, yeah. Now, I'm pretty happy with Monkey if I was him. This lane was going to be easy. So, I don't know. PA against Monkey in the lane, I don't think they're going to swap it out.
No, I doubt that they're going to swap it out. Who are you voting for? Who do you think is going to come out at top of this?
Alright, so I think the early game, maybe the laning is going to suck really hard for Team Ember. But after the laning, I think the mid game should be fine, because Kunkash is probably going to be very strong in this lane. And PA, I don't know, I think PA does quite well against the Monkey, doesn't he?
Yeah.
They both do well.
I mean, they're very strong heroes, but if they go 1v1, I think the PA is going to smack the Monkey very fast. I mean, the crit potential.
Right, so we see some rotation coming out from GG right now. They want that first blood.
Yep, we do see that. Are they going to smoke or are they just going to walk up? They decide.
Should the Monkey have mischiefed into a career? That's how you do it. Usual. So the Dazzle being slowed.
Dazzle is going to die.
Celestial Hammer. CM and then
a high five popped out. Not going to get that high five, but it does seem like there's two ruins going both ways. PA wants to go on this, immediately jumping on him.
He actually gets it.
He gets it, so that's three ruins to the side of Team Ember.
Now, Heka was very unhappy with that, chasing Death Hunter all the way back to his tower.
And we see a cheeky tip there from the CM to this Void Spirit. So, what do you think the lanes are going to be like? I feel like this Kunkka is going to dominate this mid lane a bit.
Yeah, no, I don't think the Void Spirit stands much of a chance. I don't think so. I mean, Kunkka is too tanky to kill.
I mean, look at that. He's almost half life from two hits. This Tidebringer does a lot of damage. But look at Bot, Dazzle, and Dawn chasing each other hard.
Beaver, be careful. You already died once. You don't want to die again.
This Dawnbreaker does not care. Keeping this Dazzle far away from this BA.
So let's have a quick look again. Both Conquer and Void Spirit transition very well into the mid game, right? I mean, Conquer can burst down the PA or the Dazzle quite easily. Sorry, not Conquer, I mean Void Spirit. Void Spirit can burst them down very easily. So they're gonna need to be very careful on their rotations.
Yeah.
Especially when this Void Spirit hits level 6. CM position 3, by the way.
That is a very interesting play. I like it.
Is it a cheeky play or is it an actual meta play?
No, I think that's a cheeky play. I really think that's a cheeky play. If you can start with introducing Top, I'll quickly have a look at the changes to her and let you know what those changes are.
Alright, well, Top we've got again, bar-wise, but this time playing an Axe and Cookie on a Hoodwink. Against Monkey Logic, Monkey King should do fine, as I said, as we both said earlier. Right, I think Monkey is going to be a very strong sustain. Is going to have a lot of sustain against this Axe. But right now it still looks okay because it's the early levels. And as soon as it turns into level 4 or 5, it's going to get rougher and rougher.
Yep,
but this Hoodwink pooling the creeps, making some space.
Yeah, that's a great pull. Almost got a whole creep wave down.
Yeah.
Well done.
Ooh, Hoodwink, don't give him Jingu Mastery.
So close. Now he's gonna. Oh. Off HP Hoodwink.
Dazzle going down again against a CM.
So, just by the by, CM doesn't have a lot of changes. Basically just do her arcane aura, which means that it doesn't apply to everyone, and there's no longer she doesn't cast it anymore. It's an aura, and only allies within the radius receive that buff of 1200. So it's a self bonus factor has been increased. So for yourself, instead of 3 mana per second, you get 4 mana per second. And the mana bonus has been rescaled. So basically not much has happened to her. But the combo between between CM and Dawnbreaker is actually disgusting. So if CM slows and Dawnbreaker slows, you are slowed by a total of, where's this, 24.
Well, here we see the Dawnbreaker going onto the PA. PA actually dying.
That's 56.
To the slow and stun.
Yeah, that's 56% slow. At level 1. 56%
slow. That's rough. I don't think you can fight against that all alone. You're going to need your Dazz to at least stand with you.
And at max level, the slow is 86%.
I mean, are we even going to see that? Because right now,
well, ooh, Cookie does
Hoodwink
come
keeping
in.
Water. Bushwhack hitting the CM, but the PA again getting stunned and disabled.
Just look at this damage.
Ooh, joining the battle. Healing up the CM. Dazzle might actually. Yeah, well, he's definitely gonna. Wow. Okay, so the Dawnbreaker gets the kill. I thought the CM was gonna get it. So, yeah, no, this is ridiculous.
This
actually.
Lane
Monkey
is...
King is going to be fine against lane with an Axe, but again, in this bottom lane, this tri lane versus tri lane, seems like the CM's lane is going to win this. Right now, at least.
So, honestly, with the changes made to PA, I think she should just go jungle. We see.
Already?
This lane is so bad, she's dying a lot.
Well,
she's
Warlock
gonna die. Is she gonna die again? She dies again.
Stunning the PA. PA does have a lot of one charges though.
Already used. Is she gonna do something? This Warlock keeping up the sustain.
Bushwhack onto the CM. CM getting healed though by the Warlock. So these fights, wow. Dazzle coming up with a grave. Not needed though, I didn't think it was.
Yeah, and we've got Haste on the Void Spirit coming in looking for that Dazzle. Gonna get it. Taking a bit of time, though.
TM.
Gives it to the CM. I mean, yeah, four heroes committed for the Dazzle.
Even Kuka came to try and help. And as you said, the PA seems to be jungling.
Yeah.
He's done with those lane.
I would max out Phantom Strike. Forget about the Stifling Dagger and just start farming. You cannot lane against this, but they need to be careful. I mean, Warlock's already here spotting this. They're gonna get a kill. Are they gonna get a kill?
If they do, they're gonna take really long. I mean, he just deeps out.
Yeah. They do spot that ward, but they do know now that the PA is jungling, so this is very scary for this PA. Gunka still bot, trying to do something with his bot lane.
Seems like they've swapped it up a little bit.
Yeah.
They go mid.
But they are allowing this Void to get a lot of farm. Well, should be, because if he was mid, he would have been able to kill Hoodwink quite easily. He does a lot of burst damage. But Axe also moved into the jungle. Ah.
No, I mean, the monkey is... He's not going to be chased out of this thing. As a matter of fact, I feel like the monkey actually chases the Axe.
Yeah.
And Axe does have Vanguard, so he's...
Quite janky,
so yeah,
but he's...
He can jungle easily. It's pretty fine for him right now. But yeah. Everybody's just jungling. And...
That's a smart move. And this move to take Kunkka bot, is, I think, is very important because the PA was going to keep dying every single time. This lane, the slow is just so rough. And
but now the Hoodwink is in danger, though.
Yeah, the Hoodwink is in danger, but he should be alright. He's got a lot of escape, bushwhacks, acorn shots.
Right, are we seeing a Void rotating into the jungle? Is PA going to get spotted out?
PA is in blur, so she won't. They won't see him.
Kunkka.
They saw... Gunka should
might
be very...
Gunka,
there are four people there. You might be dead.
And here we go. Boat used. Only hits the Dawnbreaker. It doesn't matter because he just dies.
So this CM, which played Earthshaker in the previous game, is having another great lane.
Great lane? Like, he's got three kills. And he's got two bracers. He's tanky as well. Like, you think he should be? She should be the soft target. No, no.
As I said, she's going to be the front line. So that's going to be quite interesting to see. We do see all three of the cores on the side of GG Kappa have the net worth or the lead in net worth. We've got Void at first. CM second and Monkey at third, and then we've got all five heroes of Team Ember. So there's only a 1k, less than a 1k lead, so it's not that hard. But there's six kills on the side of GG Kappa and none on
the
side.
And the Kunkka is gonna get gone on by the Void Spirit again.
My goodness,
quick rotation, he didn't even pop the double damage in his bottle.
They really do not like this bot tower.
They really don't like anybody who's in the bottom tower as well.
Hoodwink misses his sharpshooter. Very unfortunate. But this game seems to be so slow. It's like the Axe is just farming, the PA is just farming. And then GG Kappa are looking for those pickles. Monkey going to see this Phantom Assassin.
Well, the Dazzle is behind the PA, so we should be fine.
Yeah,
everybody
is
catching
now.
The Monkey is in a really tight spot.
No, he is in
it. Are we going to see a Culling Blade? And there we go. First Culling Blade of the game.
Yep. And Axe is getting that armor. We do see double damage on the Void Spirit.
So bottom tower seems she's taking that by herself.
Yeah, she's like the ES game, just enjoying the fun time of having a free lane.
Kunkka gone on again. Quite tank. Gets
both actually hitting Hekka, but he's still gonna die. Even Solar Guardian used.
Misses.
Thank misses. Goodness not needed, but he is here to join the fight.
Yeah. Monkey waiting to see them.
Tower fell, and now Mid should go down as well.
Yep.
So it seems like the lanes were completely dominated by GG Kappa and the mid game. Does not look good right now.
So I don't think the lanes were dominated. It was only bot with the CM that.
Yeah, but they had to sacrifice the Kunkka.
Yeah, I don't think that was the right play.
Who died twice?
I don't think that was the right play. Oh my word.
PA gonna get caught out as well. I mean, there's no way Monkey. Right?
Misses.
Monkey thought. Okay, so Monkey goes rather on the dazzle, it seems. Okay, well, the PA gets out then.
Yeah.
Dazzle's sacrificing himself.
Brilliant play. Always keep your carry safe.
Given his life, always the right thing to do. I wish they actually had a centaur on GG Kappa, and then we can see the Agnums on the centaur combo with the CM.
That would be great.
Would have been funny.
So, CM's just staying and farming up. She's not caring. Invis on the Void Spirit.
What's Pierre gonna do? If he goes on her right now, I think he actually dies. So, boat utilized onto the Witch Doctor. Culling Blade, unfortunately, not gonna be on time because of Hekka.
But you mean the Warlock, not the Witch Doctor?
Yes. Why did I say Witch Doctor?
No idea. But we do see Crystal's going for Yakaya and Sanj, so she is gonna get tankier and tankier.
Definitely gonna be a problem eventually.
This
she's
PA should die.
PA gonna get Celestial Hammered along with the Void Spirit comboing her down.
This is quite rough.
Monkey alone against the Kunkka and Dazzle top, by the way, and just doesn't care. He's perfectly fine.
That is quite rough. We see the game is just getting further and further out of reach of Team Ember. 84% win rate to GG Kappa right now.
Already?
Yeah, 14 minutes in the game.
That is a bit much.
This monkey.
I mean, even the Dawnbreaker is just. What's his name? Sukablyat, right?
Yeah.
He's farming the jungle, the Radiant Jungle. Anyway.
I mean,
so now they've got three people onto the monkey. Are they going to actually catch him? Monkey does use his Wukong's command. Solar Guardian also being used. Both getting both of them. But it seems like they're going to try and back.
But
this Dawnbreaker going to die? No.
No one's dying. Everyone's still alive. Why is everyone still alive?
Monkey gonna kill. Wait, no, that's actually the Dawnbreaker getting the kill on the PA. How is Dawnbreaker still alive? Swinging the Dazzle on the Dawnbreaker. But now we've got a Void Spirit joining the fight. Monkey is just healing up with that Jingu Mastery. What a turn in that fight. Like, it seemed like nobody was gonna die, but then almost everybody died.
Yeah, and it's fight like these.
Kunkka also died. Unfortunately, he was standing right underneath the sentry. Right?
It just feels like this game is getting so out of hand very fast. I mean, these people are just keep going in. Dazzle,
shallow
brilliant
wave,
save, but I mean, that's not going to be enough. Dazzle's also going to go down, most likely.
Oh, what a call from the axe.
Oh, he missed the Culling Blade.
So
why did he not
like
use Battle Hunger?
And the Dawnbreaker just killing off the PA. PA is still surviving. Oh no, we've got the Void Spirit jumping. Killed her off.
Boat onto three.
Hitting three. Monkey is still standing, man. Just healing up from his Jingo Mastery still.
This has been such a rough fight. My goodness.
You see this PA dying twice in, what, a minute?
And CM wasn't even in that fight, by the way.
Yeah, she's having her own single player game.
Yep. PA does smoke up alone.
Well, he's gonna go into the enemy triangle, it seems. He's like, no, they're just gonna play too aggressive. If they do that, then I'm just gonna chill in their own base. Or jungle, I mean.
Yeah. Smart play. I don't think there's anything else you can do right now. There are a few stacks, but I mean, she hasn't even got enough to take these stacks. She's so squishy, she had to get Morbid Mask just to go jungle. Even with the changes.
Right, smoke up coming from GG. Seems like Void Spirit's smoke is gonna break onto the Conqueror. And he does dive onto the Dazzle. The axe blinking in, falling. Almost hitting everybody.
Almost hitting everybody, but hitting nobody.
Getting a bush right onto the Warlock and the Void Spirit. But the monkey is just running on top of this. So, what is the Solar Guardian?
That was just to get into the fight, I guess. Axe getting away, I have no idea how. He was so low.
Yeah, no, the Void Spirit chose to go into the Hoodwink and Kunkka. Well, Kunkka Torrent boats almost hitting them. I think that would have been pretty good if they had that, but
yeah.
It seems like nothing's going their way.
I mean, right now, we said you need to ban the Earthshaker, which I don't even think they did. But they didn't need him.
Yeah, no, that. CM? What has the CM done? Apart from the laning phase, I think she's just been farming.
Literally, she's been farming.
What item is coming to her now? A shard. Okay, that makes her dance around while her fusing field's up.
Yep, so she doesn't need a guard. I don't know why they are looking for these fights. I mean, they are not strong enough.
On to the Warlock and the Dawnbreak. Bushwreck also hitting both
of them. On to two. Kill on Warlock.
Snipes out the Warlock. Call on the Dawnbreaker, Culling Blade. There we go, another stack. I think that's... Oh, it's the third one. Alright, let's see. Hoodwink and the Dazzle dead. CM joining the fight, by the way.
This is the first fight she's been in, and...
So this Void Spirit is just chasing down that.
She hasn't got Blink.
PA is right next to the fight. And it seems like Hacker is gonna spot him out.
But not going on him. I don't think he has enough mana to go on him.
Probably. Well, now he runs into a Warlock and he doesn't even want to fight this Warlock.
I don't think he can. If Warlock pops out, he's dead.
Yeah, well, anybody can just TP in as well, so right now the monkey is moving around top, even scan used. Wait, an axe call misses.
Axe taunting them with the biggie.
This is just too aggressive. Pace of the game is just too much to handle for Team Ember.
And I mean, that's what you said. GGK are gonna go in, run in and fight, get a lead for their Monkey King, which they've done. Secure these lanes, push out towers.
I thought the mid game was at least gonna go a little bit better than this, you know, but the CM is just... I mean, we haven't really seen the CM fights. By the way, the Monk, the Axe calls... Vincent calls
Solar
the Monkey,
who's
just full HP, probably. Oh no, wait, he does use his BKB. And his Wukong's command, Axe is gonna die. This freaking Dawnbreaker with no HP surviving this fight.
Axe used Culling Blade on the Monkey King instead of the Dawn. It would have killed the Dawn, and it didn't kill the monkey.
Well, we've got Barwise eventually killing down Dawnbreaker. Funka is gonna go on this.
But Monkey King's just gonna come back in.
Monkey wants to help his teammate along with this.
Oh, Torrent.
Wow, what a Torrent. This is gonna make a difference. Bushwreck as well coming on. This
Acorn
Monkey
shot
is
going
so
in.
He's dead, but again, he's got Jingle
doesn't
Master.
Do anything.
Wow.
See him at the back of the tower. Is
he
gonna die?
Use the dancing field, and this is gonna kill the PA. Oh wow! The PA.
Dazzle.
Gonna kill.
Dazzle
PA
gets that. Is it PA?
No, it's both of them.
It's a shared gold. But I mean, goodness.
This fight was insane. I can't believe this monkey keeps getting away with almost nothing. How unlucky can you get on Team Ember?
No. At this point, they have so little damage, it's really rough.
I mean, these bushwhacks on Cookie this has been insane. He's really trying his best, and he's doing well.
Yeah. We have to say, like, in the previous game as well, Cookie played so well on that Dawn, making sure that he saves a ton of people in his Solar Guardian, but also now in this game, making plays with the Acorn shots with the bushwhacks, I mean, it's really doing well. I wonder if GG Kappa can actually go Roche. I think they have enough damage. It's going to take a while, though, but I think they have enough damage. But do they even need to? I mean, 14k lead right now. 97% win probability.
Yeah, no. 3% chances. I mean, I guess you're still in the game.
You're still in the game, you still haven't lost all your Axe, but I mean...
Alright, it seems like Axe is gonna go on, get gone on by the Dawnbreaker. Void Spirit just jumping on top of the Dazzle, who's going to try and save the Axe, but dies to Hecker, and
Axe is also gonna go down.
Right after.
Okay, so this game is steamrolling out of the hands of Team Ember.
You know, PA not even close to Deso yet. Well, I guess he's kind of close, 400 gold. But still, that's gonna be her first item.
At, yeah. Like,
24, 25 minutes.
I mean,
the lane was
I
just.
I don't even think it's gonna make a difference right now.
Aghanim's on this Void Spirit. He's playing so aggressive.
Yeah.
There's nothing Team Ember can do.
And I really thought the Skunkka against the Void Spirit would have been better, but it just didn't. He had to rotate bot to try and help PA out and just win that lane.
Used Axe Shallow Grave to survive a little bit longer. Solar Guardian also
both used connecting on three.
But all of them are still alive.
But look how fast this
Axe buyback.
I mean, Dazzle just killed Dawnbreaker by the poison touch. That was quite good. But I mean, they saved this tower, which is brilliant. But they did buy back on the Axe. There's 140 gold exchange to the side of Team Ember, which is good because it's the first positive fight they've had in the game so far, I feel.
You know, the CM is gonna go BKB, right? And apart from the Axe call, there is nothing that's gonna stop the CM.
I haven't
seen she is tanky. She's got a blink. She's pretty much just gonna wait for this Axe to call anybody except her, and then she's gonna blink in and start to ult everybody down.
Yeah, and I mean, what are you gonna do?
Maybe that's not even needed, by the way, because it seems like they are gonna rush.
Yep, they are in Roche pit now. It's gonna take a while, though. I mean, even with double damage on Monkey. Not sure. So, CL, do you think there's any way that Team Ember can bring this game back?
Well, Dota apparently thinks they can. They've got a 2% chance, but it really doesn't look to me like they, I don't know, this is just too much to deal with right now. The monkey is just gonna jump on top of everybody, use Wukong's command, and somebody is going to die. There's just nothing that can stop that. And then there's Void Spirit with an axe to silence that Dazzle.
And he's gonna do that.
Even if Dazzle does get Shallowgrave off, that person will still die because he's gonna be slowed, he's gonna be stunned.
Can the PA even take out this Dawnbreaker though? I don't even think so.
Nah.
She DPs out because she doesn't even think she can. I don't even think she can.
Alright, you see a Solar Guardian being used on top of the axe. Vote hitting the Dawnbreaker. BKB being used by the monkey to kill that axe down.
Yep.
Alright. Now what?
Dawnbreaker, is she gonna make it?
Do you even need to use Wukong's command there?
Maybe to secure the tower?
I mean, that tower is tough right now. Why is it so strong? What's going on here? Oh no, Kunkka actually getting caught out. But Shallowgrave is going to save him for a few seconds longer.
And does save his life.
Nice. That was a very good save from the Daz. Is it going to be enough? I don't know. Tower does fall.
It did take them a long time.
Seconds. That is their initiation. Again, they're getting gunned by this Void Spirit. They're just hitting this Rex. It's too much of a lead. 21k and the level difference. What is the level difference? 16 levels? Oh.
That's a whole hero. We do see.
A whole hero!
We do see that Dota does not think that Ember can bring this back.
100% win probability. Well, let's find out. There was a Culling Blade on what? A creep or something?
I think it was a creep, yeah.
Might have been a monkey illusion.
Could be.
Oh boy. Alright, so it seems like Team Ember is not going to give up. They're still trying to find a way. Woodwink goes down to the Void Spirit, Shallowgrave to keep the axe alive.
Dazzle just dies so fast. Does save
so this game, who do you think the MVP is here this time? Probably Hekka? He really did play very well with those rotations.
Yeah, he did very well. PA blinking in but dying instantly.
Yeah. Now the CM, the CM did.
And GG is called. Team Ember have had enough.
The lead that GG Kappa got from the lanes, it was just too much to deal with in the mid game. Team Ember couldn't do anything. They had to sacrifice the Kunkka from mid lane going into the safe lane so that just the PA can go in the jungle.
That was really hard for them. They need to find a way to secure those off lanes, especially in such a hard lane, without having to rotate the Kunkka or their mid. Because, Kunkka had a fine lane and he would have been enabled a lot more if he stayed mid than going down bot just to save that tower from falling immediately.
Even Axe actually had a fine lane against that. It's just that bottom lane was just.
It's so strong.
Yeah.
They had such a strong bottom lane, GG Kappa. Well done to them, winning game 2. That is 2-0 for GG Kappa against Team Ember. We are going to take a short break, and then we're going to jump into our second 2-game series for Team Ember. And we'll see you in a bit.